forward to returning to the Bastion of Hope after a long time away from the Nightly Stronghold. Although the circumstances might have been happier, it was time for the heroes to see if they could save the knights and the wizard Valerius from the most terrifying of fates. The knights from being all turned into stone, and Valerius from being enslaved by the Clockwork Army.
Oh, I remember the first time we sailed here. I was only a little boy swabbing decks on my father's ship.
A ship? Pontius, you never told us of these adventures.
Well, the thing was, I would always get seasick out in the open water. So, my sister got the ship and I got to keep my land legs. The Bastion of Hope will never surrender. Not as long as I'm here.
Hello, little brother. There's a spot of trouble in the kingdom, although I guess you've caught wind of it already. Wouldn't have taken you for one to blow up a castle or to get locked up in dungeons. Whatever is going on there, good luck with it. Me, I've a tide to catch.
Oh, a letter from my sister. That's nice. She usually never writes.
Thank you.
This port is where I first met my fellow knights.
What a shame it's in ruins now.
Stuck-up brutes made an everlasting impression on little Pontius.
Enough reminiscing. Come on, it's time we leave our own marks on those treacherous tin men.
Immense. It just keeps on going.
You get a good workout just running from one place to another here.
Well, how are we to know which one of the clockwork monsters has stolen Valerius's magic powers?
Let's look for more petrified knights. Eventually, we should find the source.
Thank you. dismantle every rock in the Bastion of Hope and transport them back to the capital.
Over my dead body.
This is an interesting little workshop.
The new airship hangar. Not sure airboats are any better than sea boats.
Maybe after all this, I should take Margaret on an airship trip.
Thank you.
Here's where we had a great big celebration after I became a knight.
I'm guessing the place was in better shape at the time.
Those clockwork knights don't really seem to care for architecture or public safety.
A knightly headpiece. A knightly headpiece.
four petrified knights.
I hate to say this, but poor fellows.
Magics are inside the lizard.
To show up. Thank you.
More petrified knights.
I hate to say this, but poor fellows.
Your friend's magics are inside the lizard.
What role did the cabbage cart play in solving the puzzle?
This is extraordinary.
And disconcerting.
I think this belongs to Valerius. But what if it's not his? What if it's, I don't know, Wilhelmina's? Will we end up with Wilhelmina in Valerius's body?
Your fancy pants is right. We should study this first.
Yes, I propose a hands-on experiment.
What happened to all the metallic monsters? Amadeus, when did you get here?
Looks like we delivered our part of the deal. Now we need your help in taking down Sunny and Godric.
And finding my children.
And restoring the knighthood!
Let's see what we can do.
With her powers of clairvoyance, the seeress Barbara had found the location of the villain's magnificent airship. The wizards of the observatory even let our heroes borrow their air cycle to get up to the clouds. But what sort of adversity would the heroes now meet, facing Lady Sunny, Lord Godric, and their clockwork minions, all the while soaring through the skies?